get it whenever we got like
still not had this.
4 or 5 people going back to back to back to back.
Oh yeah. Is that when it's fun?
Yeah.
Oh yeah.
We've got 4 of us all here.
Yeah.
All gone.
Yeah.
Who's taking all of this garbage?
It might not be garbage.
I'm gonna
open the face of my stuff.
Well,
you looking at my hand.
Whoever wins is the person who doesn't have the garbage. They get everybody else's garbage.
Cuts anybody?
I get to start at 45, right?
Negative.
Boom! First.
So what we do is we both five packs, and we open it in a very specific way.
You're gonna need land tax again.
Why does it say your last name?
What?
It says player 4.
1, 2, 3, 4. It's just.
Oh, it's not the turtle.
No.
Okay.
I will keep. Right, Caleb.
Babe.
Keep. All right. First turn draw. Island pass.
I'm like on 8
turns
against
every
shot.
Hey, Mark.
Done here. No, it's kind of
fun. It's probably playing some pass.
Who wins the first play?
Island pass.
Draw. Mountain pass. That is a warped landscape.
That is Howling Mine.
Woo woo!
The leech draw two?
Yes. While Howling Mine is untapped, we draw an additional card during our draw step.
Untapped for no reason.
No. Close drop for retreats. And Boros Signet and pass turn.
Draw 1, draw 2.
You gotta give a guy a chance.
I did last night.
I'm gonna play an island.
Let's see all of these cards.
Gonna play a soul ring.
Yeah.
Do you wanna get mine?
Gonna play.
One more time.
Here. Manolith. Pass turn.
Look at Banner Rock City. Draw? Additional draw? I will play an island.
Alright, now I'm
going to dump. 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. I'll go ahead and pay 2 for an Izzet Signet. Pass.
Second draw. Mansfield.
Hi.
Pass turn.
What can I do for you?
Trip 2.
How much are the dragon seeds?
690. Elven Memory's Call, 287.
Oh, how many?
This is our library, it was $2.86. Oh, we're going to the tape.
That's mine, I'm thinking.
Okay.
I'm going to active authority the Howling Mine.
Passing.
Howling Mine is exiled. Forever.
Yeah. Doing your card draw.
It would have helped your approach.
That's probably right there on the bottom.
I'm going to play Zora's Gateway.
Hey, you found your second target, Eric.
I did, actually.
Better.
That's fun. So,
I don't know. It's not even worth exiling.
Yeah.
You're just going to get rid of it.
The flip half is worth exiling.
I'll give you a few turns to try to get rid of this before I get rid of that.
It won't work.
Let her exile the 4 cards.
That's what I'm saying. I gotta get some value out of it.
Thing is, I don't really want to exile anything. So.
Well, that's why you draw a card and you exile a land. That's your 0 cost.
I'll try. But what if I need the land?
Then you don't exile the land.
Yeah, and then you're screwed.
I'm screwed.
Ooh.
I guess guess this one is the least staple right now.
I don't think I ever would have exiled that card. Okay.
Alright, fine.
Untap, upkeep, draw, command tower. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 is a good number, so we're going to play Karos, God of Storms. Pass.
Keep going. It was just before. Yeah, that one right there.
Grand Dynamo?
Sure.
And then I force search for tomorrow. Pass turn.
It's untapped, actually. That's why that card is so good off of suspend. Go on turn three, you just go get your fourth land.
Ice Crown Scepter?
What's that do?
It has imprint. When it comes into play, I can exile instant card with CMC 2 or less from my hand. And it's basically imprinted on that, so I can pay 2 and tap it and cast a copy of that spell. And I will imprint Lightning Helix.
Oh god, this is bad.
3 damage to target creature or player?
Yep.
And gain 3 dice.
Yep. And I'll pass turn.
Once his general is out, it's gain 6, right?
Yep.
It's super good when
it's gain 6 and deal 6.
It's great when you insult injury and play that with your the commander out. Because since it's a red and a white spell, that gains me life and deals damage. I'll gain 6 life and, you know, 6 damage.
I get to reveal the top 4.
The
yes.
Insult to injury and the Furnace Wrath will double it and double it again.
Alright, who's your target?
You can choose.
Caleb, you're going to make 2 piles.
Can I choose one and the other goes in the graveyard? Yep.
Correct.
Huh.
I originally had mono blue Sphinx Tribal with Unesh as the commander, and then I realized there just wasn't enough
Sphinxes
for mono blue.
Yeah.
So I branched out to Esper, because I already had an Alora deck, so I just grabbed the Sharome and the value cards. Because Alora was not a bad deck.
Yeah. Alora turns out it's a pretty good commander.
I'm at 7. Pass turn.
Untap. Upkeep. Draw trigger from Karanos. I reveal Gyarapur Orrery. I get to deal 3 damage. Let's throw it at Eric's face, because it's not going to matter anyways.
In response, I'll go ahead and lightning heal you for 3.
You're going to not change life total.
Ouch.
Land for the turn. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So, let's make everybody my friend and play Rhystic Study.
What's that do?
Whenever an opponent plays a spell, I may draw a card unless that
player
pays
one.
I'm going to play Trail of Evidence. Whenever I cast an instant or sorcery, I investigate, which is create a clue token that I can sacrifice for 2 mana to draw a card. Pass. Rampy Dampy over here should always be paying the extra one.
Well, what if I don't want to?
Do not let him draw extra
done?
Cards.
Yes.
It's the reason why I got rid of the Howling Mine.
Why don't you want me to have extra cards, Eric?
Listen, I don't even want myself to have extra cards.
Pay the one.
For the Thrasios.
Yeah.
Okay.
You're done.
All right, he's out of mana, folks.
Yeah.
Mission accomplished. Shields down. My face
there
is
were
gonna
never any shields to begin with.
No, I mean,
I don't think your deck likes this. It just it never gives me
counters.
It's
not
counters.
It's not
there's not a whole lot of counters. There's like 2.
I'm good. Yeah.
But Thrasios is like your main dig when you don't have anything to do.
Yeah.
Warped Landscape is Evolving Wilds that taps for colorless mana.
So it's better.
And
you well, you have to pay
2
to sack it. So it's not strictly Evolving Wilds plus,
it's better.
But being able to tap it for mana until you need to crack it is a good thing, in some cases. The high market is in there because there are certain spells that you just don't want to resolve.
I'm gonna pass turn.
Yeah. I'm currently in the process of making a Shadowborn Apostle deck.
Demons!
Sunken Hollow.
But I already have a
What's his name? The black-white god.
Athreos.
Yeah.
God of Passage.
Three, four, five.
That is your typical Shadowborn Apostle demon deck.
Sphinx of the Final Word.
5/5 flying, hexproof, can't be countered. Your instants and sorceries can't be countered.
And I get to do the
fact or fiction.
Yep. Eric can do it this time.
Two lands and two non-lands. The land becomes one pile. Make them choose. Do you want mana or stuff?
I'll get the stuff.
Aw, Eric was nice.
Oh, yeah, just... My thinking of it was, do you want a good land but not that great of a card, or bad land and a better card?
I mean, that's a sound logic. It's just I'm much more cutthroat. It's like, here, you can either have no mana and
I wasn't
stuff.
Paying
well, right now,
to
this
land,
is a,
or I probably would have done that.
Right now, this is basically a 2-cost 4/4, so I should probably pick this. Because of the...
That too.
Oops.
Because now she can play it.
Oh,
to
no!
Fact or fiction again.
Yeah, I'll do that.
Alright, Conundrum Sphinx comes out. Flip over 4 more cards.
Oh my.
Mana, pseudo counterspell, and Sphinx.
I feel like she takes the Sphinx just so she can draw more cards. That's my thought.
Yeah, this is what I have.
What's giving her that fact or fiction?
Unesh.
Okay.
Cryo Sphinx Sovereign.
Whenever you play a Sphinx, a fact or fiction.
Yeah.
Super good
assuming
card.
Assuming Unesh lives through the goes to the next turn cycle.
It's been out
I'm
for
hold on.
Her, yeah.
Two
no.
cards in hand.
Oh, good question. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I got your 2. That one.
Well, there goes the Evolving Wilds that she picked up.
And
a rock. All right, untapped. You didn't pay the
no,
extras.
No, she did not pay any.
Draw a trigger.
You also
island.
Yeah,
I draw an additional card.
That looks so.
All right, so land for the turn. I'm going to pay 7 for the Sphinx Bond Wand.
Ugh.
Whenever I cast an instant or sorcery spell, put a charge counter on Sphinx Bond Wand, then deal damage equal to the number of charge counters on Sphinx Bond Wand to target creature or power. So probably any target with the new rules or added. Pass turn!
Thrasios' ability.
Sure. It has been errata to any target. Reveal. A dictated group.
Should have done something here in turn, but Waka Waka.
I almost asked, but you had already picked up the card.
Yeah.
What?
I he needed to ice a Chronoscepter at the end of the turn and just...
So, how does ice a Chronoscepter read? Does it say you may cast the copy?
I was actually
copy
just...
the spell?
So, I was just looking it up and it says you may cast on the text. This one says you play a copy or play the copy without paying its mana cost.
That almost always has been errated to cast.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's the older version.
Yep, you may copy the exiled card. If you do, you may cast the copy. So, yeah. 3 mana Lightning Helix.
I admire his dedication.
Not that he didn't have the mana to do that.
That's true.
Keranos is not a creature yet. There is a mana rock over here, if that's what you're looking at.
No, I'm just weighing my options. I'm going to go ahead and pass turn.
I think this is the least I've seen you do in a game.
I would have done something if I remembered.
Approach.
That is an approach of the second sun.
Can't be countered.
Play until it's otherwise
no, no response.
Can't be countered.
Oh, that's right. Yeah. Doesn't mean we don't have a response. There are ways to deal with that without countering the spell.
Does it say you abandon that scheme or any
scheme? If it's ongoing scheme, you abandon that scheme.
No responses?
No. Nope.
I don't think if it's going to work the way I want it to do. Reverberate.
If it tells you
it is the 7.
Let me read Reverberate. What is Reverberate?
It counters or copies target instant or sorcery spell. You may choose new targets for the copy.
Okay,
but since it doesn't have a target, I wouldn't think.
No, it's copy. You are now the owner of the copy. You will be gaining 7 life. But you will not have ever cast
Approach
of the Second Sun.
Yeah.
Approach of the Second Sun has gained 7 life.
First time you cast it, it's gained 7 life. Second time you want to do it.
It's always gained 7 life.
And if you cast
life,
it the second time, it doesn't matter if it's counted or not. It technically counts as the second cast. You need a Platinum Angel.
Incorrect. It has to resolve for you to win the game.
Okay then.
All done? Untap. Upkeep, draw
yes.
trigger, evacuation.
Every
so I get to bolt. I don't like Eric bolting me back. So let's do Emily. Space.
Okay.
I mean, she did just gain 7 life.
Whoops.
Yeah.
What did I do?
So if you flip, if the next turn, if you put this in play.
Quit pushing the line.
There's a line?
Yeah, so it's.
Just tap the left or right side of the number.
Oh, okay. That makes more sense.
Yeah.
I thought I lost 3. Okay.
I'm bad at math.
That 1 life might matter later.
Yeah, you're not wrong.
Okay, now I got to switch it around. If the first cast of the first and second sentence counter is still cast towards the end.
Correct.
Yeah, yeah.
It does not matter if your first cast
the second
ever
has
resolved.
To resolve.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's fine. I did it. And that's a way to keep a balance, too. So, if you guys got it.
I'm going to gamble.
Yeah, no problem.
I love that card.
May I get a couple of dice?
You
got the D12 in here. Yep. Charge counter. We're going to deal 1 point damage to Emily's face.
I may have a response to that. Just I don't know what I get here. I'm gonna go ahead and reverberate that.
Sure.
And then I'll decide what I want to get.
Oh, the gamble. So I still take the 1 damage. Right?
Yeah. Trigger's on the stack. You will be taking 1 damage unless
you don't reveal
choice.
It, right?
No. You don't reveal it, but then you put makes your hand up and discard a card at random.
I remember that part.
Do you still get to do it or not?
What? My gamble? As long as after his is resolved, he does not have another response to gamble that stops mine from resolving, I do get to gamble. It's just there's any number of random things that can happen between now and then that would interfere with my choices. So
cuts.
You technically have to wait for the other person to finish resolving.
I just realized I can resolve the arm issue by moving it.
Reroll on a 6?
Yep. 3.
Blasphemous act. Is that what you tutored?
It is what I tutored for.
Alright. Any other responses? I shall gamble. And that, my friends, is why it's called gamble.
And that's why I will not put that card in this deck. Because I never get it.
I put that in here so I had a reliable way, well, as reliable as you can, to tutor an enchantment.
Yeah.
Which it turns out red and blue are very terrible at.
Yeah.
Because, yeah, all the ways they would be able to do that are so expensive, like Planar Portal or Ring of Extinguish.
Can I get, like, another.
Because it turns out those
dice.
Are artifacts that are worth 5 or 6 million.
I'll grab this. 10. I get my clue token from Trail of Evidence.
Hey, I have an idea card for that deck if you wanted to straight up tutor it by the Storm onto the battlefield. It's called Planar Portal.
Terrible card.
No, it's really bad.
Okay.
It costs so much mana.
Did you get to 8?
There's a D8 in there. It's a risky study. One. Guess what I tutored?
That?
Summary dismissal.
We're bad at tutoring.
Because summary dismissal doesn't counter, it exiles all other spells and abilities.
Yeah.
Turns out, would have been a good way to get rid of Approach of the Second Sun.
Well, I was trying to Blasphemous Act to get rid of the
the dude.
The Sphinx problem.
Yeah.
Are you done with the battle bomb box?
I'm going to go ahead and cast Reach Through Mists.
Yes.
Trigger to draw a card. Trigger to deal 2 damage to Emily's face. Draw.
The Game Nights guys are going to come after me for using their app on this video.
No, I don't.
I highly doubt it too. Free advertising.
Alright, 7 cards in hand. I will pass the Z turn.
At least I think it's the wrap.
I am going to pay the extra
something from those guys
that.
One time.
Sure.
Actually.
Then
yeah.
I did
4 for Flash.
Yeah, I did the
sure.
whole. At the end of the episode, they give away free stuff. I did basically just subscribe to it. I was like, okay, that's cool.
That's a commit to memory, folks. You draw a card.
That seems good.
That works, I suppose. Untap, upkeep.
Commit is also a good way to deal with Approach of the Second Sun, as it does not counter the spell.
Unless I
prefix.
Well, I mean, by casting Commit targeting the spell, it puts it back into your library instead of resolving.
Mm-hmm.
And it gets around Sphinx to the final word because it does not counter the spell.
Yeah. I thought you meant him shuffling my deck. I was like, what if he puts it at the top?
Which I have actually had happen. I played Approach of the Second Sun, and as I was going to draw it, After like the draws had resolved, I had someone do a wheel effect to make it go away.
Yeah.
And in the 7 cards that I drew Approach the Second Sun.
Seems good.
Lantern turn. Let's move there. After that. Awesome. Guggen's inside.
Sure. As
nice.
The spell resolves, you scry X, where X is the highest converted mana cost among permanents you control. At this point, it is 6. Is he drawn?
Responses?
Any responses?
Nope.
All right. Scry 6, and then draw 3.
That.
Card is hilarious with an Eldrazi on the field. I'm going to scry 10.
That.
That's
And that's why it's good. Honestly, what sucks is when you want to see all of the cards that you're scrying and you have to figure out what order you want to see them in. Did you pay for that? You said you did, right?
No.
You did not pay for that.
I won't.
Okay.
Ask the turn, discard one.
In your turn, I'll bolt, but I don't know who or what.
Are you paying the one?
So ability, so no.
But you're
make
casting
a sting.
The lightning, Felix. We just had that conversation.
But wouldn't that be play? That's his place.
It spell. Is the same thing. Whenever an opponent casts a spell, I may draw a card unless that player pays one. And he is casting.
Just because of that, I'm going to get you.
He deserves it.
You're not wrong.
Have you even cast Kaido?
No, he has not cast Kaido. He's more digging than ramping right now.
That's fair. Yeah, mana's not exactly an issue for him, so.
He seems fine.
We're drawing two a turn now?
Yeah. Eric, did you draw your additional card from Dictated Groupix?
Did not.
I'm glad she said something before you started playing.
Me too. Play Windborn Muse and pass the turn.
And Windborn Muse is white propaganda on a stick?
Yep.
Okay. Is it for one or two?
Two.
Okay. At the end of his turn, while you're still tapped out, evacuation.
God.
Return all creatures to their owner's hands.
Take three.
You.
What?
Sphinx is gone. I'm doing everybody a favor.
I know. I'm doing myself a favor.
Fine. Sphinx Bone Wand trigger. I'm going to deal 3 damage to Emily's face.
Alright.
Really?
I don't know why you even bother. I have the Sphinx thing. She's covered. Unless she has another counter.
She was going to factor fiction for every Sphinx she played until she saw Approach of the Second Sun. Now she has to
replay
everything.
It stalls her out for at least a good 2 turns. Oh yeah, that's right. There's still a Dictated Crucifix. We forget these things.
Hey guys, who can math? What's the next card in her deck?
I mean, it's fine. She can't win if she can't cast it.
Okay. You have.
Oh. Not okay with that, Eric.
I'm 100% okay with this.
With what?
Nothing. It's fine.
You missed the conversation.
It's fine.
What do you have?
Nothing.
You
it's fine.
Nothing. It's fine.
Don't look at my hand. Get in the drink.
No, I already know what it is. Jeez.
I what
does he have?
Nothing. It's fine. What? Oh, she used Azor's Gateway, so it is officially in her hand.
She still has nowhere near enough to gas it, though.
Yeah, she has one mana left.
I'm going to move the discard.
Discard approach.
Can somebody get rid of the Azor's Gateway?
I used the wrong one.
Okay. Okay. Pass. You can.
I can. I completely forgot.
It's just it gives it to her. Untap, upkeep, draw trigger. I'm going to reveal an island and draw an additional card.
It's fine. She can get rid of the Sphinx Bone one that's been causing her so much grief.
I agree.
But then he can take some of my stuff.
I mean, he'll just start going around the table until everything's gone.
I'm going to play a Goblin Electromancer. My instants and sorceries cost one less to cast.
That's maybe actually the thing that we need to get rid of.
Honestly, if you get rid of that, she's going to get rid of that, he's going to get rid of that.
Yeah, oh, believe me, I know this is living on borrowed time.
I mean, I've been really nice and let it sit.
That's the reason why I haven't put a, I can't remember what it's called, Paradox Engine in here. That just seems mean.
Well, since I have a pseudo idea of what's going on here, I'm going to cast Commit, targeting Unesh. Or not targeting Unesh, I'm going to target the Azor's Gateway. Trigger. Sphinx Bone 1 goes up to 4, and I'm going to deal 4 damage to Unesh. Second from the top. And Unesh takes 4.
So it's 10 volumes long, and it has a beginning, middle, and
end. And 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
If she casts it again, does it still see those cards that was exiled with it?
No.
Okay.
No. They're just permanently in exile now.
Okay.
She has to re-exile 5 cards. Which is the card's major drawback. But when it flips, oh my god.
I've only flipped it in single player or 1v1 matches, but yeah.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Karanos is still not a creature. Pass turn.
I'm into your step. Cracking this. Cracking this.
So does she have it in hand?
Yes, it is in her hand. Confirmed. She drew a card with Azor's Gateway. After she had done the Unesh, which makes card number 7.
Go right under it.
Thank you.
So just flash it to everybody, it's fine. I honestly didn't see it either, but...
Did something happen?
He dropped a card and I picked it up and I was like showing it at him, but at you too, so...
And we weren't in the
totally oblivious.
I was too, and I was like,
I got hit by an oblivion sower. Bad magic puns.
Is there a good magic pun? No, there is not.
Now I'm going to try really hard to think of one.
So I was kind of sad that the Planeswalker Commander out of the second anthology wasn't Teferi. I'd have been the happiest guy if there was a foil Teferi Walker.
Oh, there's the foil Teferi Walker. It's just not out of Commander.
Thrasios.
Okay, no, that's true.
Oh my gosh.
You can draw again.
Hello. No one has flying.
I did. You guys dealt with me.
He has played gravity well. Creature. Whenever a creature with flying attacks, it loses flying until end of turn.
Pass turn. Pass turn more than anything else.
Has everyone played Frost Monster?
We haven't.
Okay.
So...
I really don't want to do this and give people the board state.
Oh.
again. Before that resolves, I'm going to tap two. And let's hit you just because you're a medium 40.
Did you pay one?
I did not. You can have it.
Australian.
Yep, Australian.
Either I answered that or I answer her.
Well, everyone.
Oops. You're not as affected by Armageddon, though.
Because you have mana rocks.
I've got a mana rock, but I have to have a land.
I'm going to float two mana. Just let me know before you change phases.
The issue here
right
is that he has Rhystic Stone.
I'm
going
to use that two mana
to
crack the draw card.
It's basically
going to
means guaranteed.
Float my mana. These Thrasios. See if I can get it.
You have the mana to play it.
That's good.
Yeah. Why did you put that other card?
Let's spell Abby.
It's only colorless to activate it?
Yeah, but it takes five.
Yeah.
It takes five and five creatures.
No, it's five and tap and alive to make a dude. And then it's five colorless and five dudes, too.
Yeah.
Yeah. What? There's a really sweet soul ring to target with that active
ability.
That's also a sweet enchantment out there.
Yeah, but you know she's going to hit something of mine after.
That's true.
Untap, upkeep, draw trigger from Karanos. I reveal an island and draw an additional card.
Here's the thing. I don't want Monopoly in my house. I love you. This is why we're friends. Even as a joke, I don't want Monopoly.
Play an island.
Turns out that game's a sin.
Turns out everything's a sin if you read the Bible. Oh, since the sorcery's cost on this. Doesn't matter. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 6, 7. No, I gotta discard something else. That's gonna feel too terrible.
Man, do you guys play D&D?
So we've tried to get several campaigns going.
You don't know
one of the functions.
Alright, so this is gonna feel like a gut punch to everybody else. I'm gonna pass turn discarding Island, Mountain, Island, and the Unspeakable.
What does he have planned?
He's probably got a ton of other land.
Put a land on the battlefield. My go.
Like I said, it's going to feel like a gut punch to everybody else.
Oh my.
Except this dude, who just played a Reliquary Tower and is now super happy. I think you just Thrasios every turn for as much mana as you can for the rest of the game. I forgot my extra draw. So I'm going to discard another mountain.
There's something that really could play to the game. So there's a lot of
One floating.
Awakening Zone.
Let's do Thrasios. I will reveal that.
Tap.
Pass turn.
Generally speaking,
she really wants that Sphinx Born
because you only had it in
you.
You were the problem.
Listen, you've got Mana Rocks too.
And you have more than I do.
Yeah.
He has a Dreamstone Hedron. It draws cards.
If I sack it.
Listen, I'm not going to use this if you guys don't come at me.
Okay.
Fair.
I was going to give it back to you. No.
I know you were going to give it back to me by getting rid of that.
No, a different way, but okay. I didn't think about that.
She wanted to commit it.
Oh, shit. Pass turn. Get out of here.
Yes.
Do you have the cyan tokens?
No, I just use dice. I just leave the dice on the Awakening Zone most of the time.
Bye from Master Predicaments. When it deals combat damage to a player, choose a card in my hand. That player guesses whether the card's converted mana cost is greater than 4. If the player guesses wrong, I can cast it without paying its mana cost.
So always say it's greater than 4 because you don't want to say less than 4 and have her cast Approach for free.
Question.
Did you tax?
No,
did
the
Ristic Study tax that card?
No, I did not.
Okay, draw a card. Untap, upkeep. Draw for the turn. I reveal Turnabout. I get to bolt. And there's just no good targets.
He's a good target.
You have the highest life total, Eric. Take 3.
They could go there.
1, 2. I really don't want to discard this thing, so I need to play that island. Memory just costs so much. Okay. So, since instants and sorceries cost 1 less, sorry, it just took me that long to find a play. I'm going to pay 4. There's a blue mana floating. I'm going to cast Turnabout for 3, choosing the most untapped mana. Sphinx Spawn Wand trigger. I'm going to deal 5 and kill the Master of Predicaments.
Really?
Sorry. And I actually don't untap my mana rock, so this play totally fizzles.
But you got a blue mana
floating. I do have a blue mana floating.
I'm not the only person to target with Sphinx on.
Listen, he got me.
Everybody else is dealt with. I guess I'll pay 1 and crack one of these clue tokens. I actually don't have to change the number since I investigated.
I'm not entirely sure he's dealt with, but...
Yeah, he's not.
I don't think you're dealt with, but I don't think you're going to pull it yourself in the face.
So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I'm going to discard Bedlam Reveler and a Queen. Because I really don't want to discard my hand right now. Yes.
Untap, upkeep, 2 draws.
I keep forgetting the 2 draws.
I think I did too. Actually, no, I did.
Go ahead and draw another card.
Yeah, it's fine.
1 colorless floating hero.
Or is it a May?
Yeah,
it's not a May.
Right. 1, 2, 3. There we go. Hero, second here.
I can finally start helping people next turn, except myself. If you promise you won't swing at me with the next Sphinx you play, I won't kill it.
I can't promise anything right now.
But
acceptable
I love
answer.
You.
You loved her, wouldn't kill her Sphinxes.
But they're gonna hurt me.
You don't. You just only have targeted me, my face, and my stuff.
Jeez.
If I target him, he hits me back. And I don't have to worry about that deck yet. And I'm getting really close to just being able to kill him.
Yeah, but you're making sure I have nothing when you guys are all.
You have a problem.
To be fair.
In
yeah.
Your hand.
To be fair, I was also making sure you had nothing because you were gonna cast Approach.
Yes, but it hurts more from him.
Desolation Twin. And I will pay the 1 for a 6 study.
Sure. I don't have a counter for that.
So.
I guess I actually do have. I response if I can read this. So, Jeremiah is a cast trigger, a cast ability, a triggered ability. When this is cast.
It says when.
Okay, so I can do something here. I'm going to trick bind the ability of Desolation Twin. Counter target activated or triggered ability, you will not receive a 10-10 token. In a split second, you cannot respond to it.
Stinks
Bone Blonde ticks up and deals 6 to your face.
Me?
Yes. And I investigate from trailing weapons.
Yes.
Those work.
Here you go.
Getting his
so turn. That's why you just take random snippets here and there and don't care about
it. Casting lightning hand, starting you. I can't pay the one.
Thanks.
Yeah. I guess that's true.
Draw two still.
Yep.
I guess so. If you hold up the Isochron mana, we can kill Desolation Twin together on my next turn.
I'm not swinging it in anyone.
Mm-hmm. I mean, they're making sure I stay open, so.
Play something big.
It's kind of hard to play something bigger than Desolation Twin without playing actual
titans. Planar Cleansing.
Emily, did you draw your additional card?
No. Baron Moore.
I think I'll discard Blood Moon too.
I mean, there are a couple cards bigger than Desolation Twin.
A couple. I said hard, I didn't say impossible.
I'm holding one in my hand that's kind of scary.
I
want to
play this. I don't have to play this, do I? I don't have to do anything. Why did I tap that? Oh. Because I was going to play something. Six, seven, eight. Fine.
She says. Like the dragon.
Zora's Gateway again.
I could really use some mana.
Last turn.
I am actually going to try and help you with that.
You're the one who
so,
Armageddon.
Listen, I had a reason for it and I didn't know you had an answer.
Revealing my first card drawn. It is an island. I draw an additional card for the turn. Additional Karanos draw. Dictative Crucifix.
It's annoying.
I'm going to play this Reliquary Tower.
It's really annoying.
One, two, three. I'm going to cast Wheel and Deal. Any number of target opponents each discards his or her hand and draw seven. All three of you. Trigger. I'm going to deal seven damage with Sphinx Bone Wand to Desolation Twin.
Go ahead and
discard and draw seven?
Yes. I draw one card.
I really do not want to get rid of these cards, but whatever.
You need mana.
Six. Ooh. Seven.
Whatever. Alright, this isn't bad.
And unfortunately, folks, that's all I can do. Pass turn. I do not have to discard because of no maximum hand size.
Two draws.
Hey.
What?
Hey, babe.
I'm mad at you. What?
I love you.
Now I don't even have an approach. I'm literally just straight open.
Void one more.
Opponents can't cast even mana spells.
What is it? We can't cast even?
Even mana spells.
Oh. That's fine.
Turns out sphinxes are odd.
How big is it?
10, 11, 9. I need to be able to cast two odd things.
Whose turn is it?
Still
his. Actually, if I reveal something that isn't a land, I can kill that.
Dude.
Greater Good. That's a card. Sacrifice a creature, draw cards equal to the creature's power, then discard three.
Pass turn.
probably hit that with active authority.
Hit what? The greater good?
Yeah. Can he cast it? It's not a cast trigger. It's an upkeep trigger. It's a triggered ability.
Oh, I was thinking wrong thing.
But yes, he can also cast it if he had to.
I'm sorry, sacrifice a creature and does what?
Draw cards equal to the power. Then discard three.
Are you gonna sack that?
If someone kills it, it's probably what's gonna happen to it.
So no. Not the way we want it.
All I need to do is flip over a non-land card.
Aaron, I'll be right with you, man.
Oh, no worries. Oh, does he need to check out? I got this. I'm not sure I'm ready.
I will play a land tax.
Whoosh! Winning! Is that why you said this isn't bad?
There's a couple pretty good cards in here. I will pass the turn.
I have more lands for a while.
Yeah. Like, ever since the Armageddon.
Yeah.
It's your turn, babe.
Both of his triggers got me lands, and then I drew into a third one.
It's on camera!
I can discard a card and it gains hexproof. And whenever it attacks, I scry 3. Last turn.
Alright. Untap. Upkeep. Draw from Karanos. Collective Defiance. I get a bolt trigger targeting Void Winnower.
Six
extra draw
left.
From Dictative Proofings.
Oh, I didn't. That's fine. I didn't draw two cards.
Go ahead and draw an additional card.
Okay.
How many cards are in your hand?
Six.
Six.
Any cards are in my hand.
I'm going to play a Temple of the False God. And this is the only way I can do this where he still is screwed over by this, so I'm sorry. I'm going to pay 6.
He's not sorry.
The CMC is 7. I only have to pay 6 for it. Temporal Cascade. Choosing we each shuffle our hand and graveyards into our library. Trigger. Sphinx Bone Wand targeting Void Winnower. You can draw the cards from Greater Good, and they will shuffle right back into your library.
Why not?
So we are doing this.
Yeah.
He's not whipping out a Force of Will,
yeah.
I can promise.
And
there is
graveyards?
Yes,
yep.
And there is no draw after this. Everybody goes to top deck.
Hey, Josh, you're the emerald.
Oh, thank
you're
you.
You're about a buck piece, so that's...
I had an Azor's Gateway in my hand.
Bonsire Rulamog was on the bottom.
Every card might as well be on the bottom now.
Anyone want to roll up?
Not really for me.
A what?
On the Walker Commanders.
Yeah. Already opened them, already traded them out.
You determine where the approach goes.
Great. Now we have no way of knowing when it comes.
I can't believe that was your bidding. Oh. That's funny.
I guess
what happened?
He edited that.
Wait, we also
shuffled
the graves?
Porta potty flying around. And
oh, really?
Dr. Drew music to him.
Which video?
Graves 2?
The
yes.
Porta potty flying around the high winds. Somebody on Reddit was like, somebody should take this video and put Dr. Hugh music to it. And he didn't, got 1 million upvotes.
I didn't see that.
I saw the. I didn't see what the Dr. Key music, but I saw the video on Tumblr.
Yes.
That got to Tumblr fast then. Or did you see it with the Dr. Hume music too?
No, I said it didn't have the music, but I saw the original video on Tumblr.
Chronic Revelation.
He just did the one with Dr. Hugh. Dr.
Hugh. Hugh, I know what you mean.
Who? I don't watch the show, so I can butcher the name right.
I love group chat.
Do you?
It's pretty inappropriate at times. And then there's those times at 2 in the morning, it's like, why are you guys talking about this? Go to bed.
2, 4, 6. And 8.
That is an ever-flowing chalice for 4. 8 is for the multi-kicker cost. Pay 2 mana as many times as you would like when you cast this spell. For every time he pays 2 mana, it enters with a charge counter. And then the rock taps for mana equal to the number of charge counters.
So, rampant growth.
Real cool, nerd.
Pass the turn.
Untap, upkeep, plant tax turn. Actually, sorry, end of your turn, I'm going to activate Isochron.
Kill him. Kill him. We're really close. After he's dead, you can kill this.
Now land tracks tax trigger.
Land tracks.
It's gonna be a great video where everybody makes fun of how I talk. Fine.
I still refuse to watch, like, I want to watch them, but I also don't want to watch the videos on YouTube that I'm in. I'm like, oh, I don't want to see this.
Nobody.
But I'm really curious.
Nobody needs to see my...
Yeah.
The only thing I don't like about Commander is the constant shuffle.
Don't play a deck where you have to constantly shuffle.
But I need to. So, still drawing 2 for turn?
Yep. Yes. I was about to ask why you have a hand, but you just searched for 3 lands,
yeah.
So.
I wonder what's in my hand.
4 of them?
I bet he drew 2 lands on top of it.
Drew 1 land, thank you very much.
Got it.
Got him, suck a nerd. Every time you land tax, you draw a land.
Not every time, but it's been
90% of the time.
One day I'll get all these lands out of my library.
I don't know about that.
She seems to have recovered well since the
Hurricane. Madomai.
Oh my.
What does this one do?
When it deals combat damage to a player, she takes an extra turn. Madomai cannot attack during extra turns.
Seems fine.
Now you come with a host there.
I mean, you can
You're
get
not
multiple
playing
extra
this, Jeremiah,
turns.
You get out of here.
The creature still can't attack
That's
during
fine.
Those extra
you
turns.
Still get
no.
A ton of extra
no.
Turns.
You get her, you get that one, and then you get
Three
one of the ones that gives an extra combat stat.
Hello.
We're awake.
Sorry.
I take 3.
I score 3.
Oh, man. Turns out I'm running that.
Did you pay for Madomai?
No.
You've missed a ton of those triggers.
I'm not paying attention.
That's
some
good.
Of them I don't care about. Some of them I'm not paying
we
attention.
We have to give people on YouTube something to point out when they're watching the video.
Untap, upkeep, draw reveal, alpha brawl. I get to deal 3 damage. Let's kill Thrasios.
Woo!
Additional draw from Dictative Prefix. Blue. Actually, I don't even have to pay the one. Blue for Sift Through Sands, draw 2 cards, then discard a card. Sphinx Boned Wand trigger. 9 to Caleb's face. Investigate trigger. Spell resolves.
Did you like insult him or something?
No. No.
No, he's just really close to going
draw
off.
Draw 2. He is really close to going off.
I have no idea what I'm doing.
Yeah.
Everybody else at the table knows what that deck does.
I don't know what the deck does.
You would
does.
Know you're really
You've
close
seen
to winning.
It. Yeah, but it doesn't mean that
I know that there's the one card, but I don't know how much it costs. I don't know where it's at, and
you
I
need
have no
mana.
Way to get it.
You need 30 mana.
3, 6, 7, 8. Min 19.
Yeah, but with Greater Good and Kaidel, you
You're
can
really
be a
close.
Lot higher than 13.
Yeah.
I'm going to pay 2 mana and crack one of these clues to draw a card. Play my land for the turn, I guess, since that seems to be the only thing I can draw. I will pay red, blue, and 1 for a Ludovic of the Necro Alchemist. Right, resolves.
What was it?
Ludovic Necro Alchemist. 1/4 at the beginning of each player's end step. If somebody other than me loses life, you may draw a card. Or that player may draw a card. Right, Karanos is a creature. Combat. Let's swing 8 into Caleb.
Scions.
Work. Pass turn. I get to draw a card at the end step due to Ludovic. Because Caleb lost life this turn.
Yeah.
No, he didn't. Oh, yeah, he
yeah,
did.
He did.
Yeah, he did.
Sphinx Bell.
He had to hit him for 9. Woo! I love my drops.
All that mana.
Mana is no longer your problem. So.
If you had not Armageddon, he would already be at 30.
That's the scary
And you already would have won.
Yeah.
That's,
that's the thing that you want us to forget about.
He had a commit in hand, so she wouldn't have won that turn, and then
sure.
I was going to memory if she didn't somehow draw it and play it.
Gotcha.
You had a response.
Let's make Thrasios.
I was going to play the Sphinx that lets me say that he can't cast a card in this one.
Another 4 for a Kaidel.
Yeah, I mean, that would work, but could you also play Approach in the same turn?
No.
Then I would have just memoried on the next turn.
True.
Oh. Actually, it's a very interesting ruling. I don't know how that works with Aftermath. Because if she names Commit, can I still cast Memory?
I believe it's 2 different cards.
It's
okay.
That player can't cast.
No, it's that card can't be cast.
Because
everybody reveals
like,
their hands and you name a card. It doesn't even have to be a card in the hand.
I don't know.
And nobody can play the card you name.
Yeah.
I think Memory is a different card though.
This is a pretty full board state over here.
Yeah.
Decree of Annihilation would be sweet.
I cannot
cast
to do.
Decree of Annihilation is
You can almost cycle it in a few turns.
Yeah.
Last turn to you. Do you want to get rid of one of those mana rocks?
I'm going
to pay
the
play that card
tax
is if you
and
bolt
you.
So, how does this work?
So, because he did that at the end of your turn, and she lost life, you get to draw a card.
That's all.
What?
Because of this.
Ludovic.
But I did the damage.
It doesn't matter who does the damage. If somebody other than me loses life in a turn, whoever's turn it is, that player gets to draw a card at the end step.
That's a dumb card.
This is where he starts Isochron Scepter-ing on his own turn. Mr. I'm at 58.
Listen, I was trying really hard not to put attention on that.
Doesn't matter if I get approach.
You're not wrong. Why we need
True.
To put a stop to this card draw.
Well, then get rid of the deck date.
Tell you what, I will start milling her for 10 every turn. How does that sound?
Does anybody want to cut?
I don't think you can do it.
Really?
Yeah,
cuts?
I don't think
anybody?
You can.
Cuts.
Sure.
So I should draw that land.
You clearly don't understand that.
Deck. All that land that I put back in your deck. You're welcome.
Yeah. Play that land for turn.
Alright. 90% of Eric's hand is land. We're good so far.
Primal Ailment.
Sure. Instants and sorceries cost one less. Once there are four or more counters on it, you may flip it.
What's the flip?
And it gets a counter for every time it casts an instant or sorcery. The flip is a land that taps for a mana of any color. When you spend that mana to cast an instant or sorcery spell, copy the spell.
Okay.
I draw two.
For when you really want stuff dead.
Would it work on the Ashdown Scepter or no?
No, because you're not casting a spell, you're activating an ability.
That's
it will
cast.
Actually...
It's
the Isochron Scepter will trigger the amulet. He'll get counters for it. But if he uses, like, once it's flipped, if he uses the flipped land to pay for Isochron Scepter,
it won't copy
the...
Okay, that's what I was asking.
Right, and that's why I said what I said. But it's also worth pointing out that what he said is also accurate.
Still one gone.
No! That's bad.
What does he do?
So the plus is not very important. It's -3/0 to a creature, and that creature's activated abilities can't be activated until her next turn. The minus is gain 2 life, draw a card. The ultimate is Static Orb. I think it's Static Orb. Each opponent may only untap 2 permanents during their untap step.
Are
Kaido and Thassios in play?
Yes, they are.
Okay.
I'll target Kaido. Plus one.
And yes, that is Static Orb.
So Kaidel is now a 0/3 with no abilities.
Until her turn?
Until her next turn.
Okay. Yay.
This is gonna suck so hard for us.
I'm gonna do 4, Eric.
In response? A deflecting palm, take 4.
See, I told you.
It prevents the combat.
So, deflecting palm is special in the sense that it changes the source of the damage. Modomai is no longer dealing combat damage, it's not dealing any damages at all. Deflecting palm, however, is dealing 4 damage to Modomai's controller. So, Modomai's ability does not trigger, and she does not take an extra turn.
Okay.
Yep.
I'm sorry, I'm just explaining for the camera.
That's fine.
Untap, upkeep, draw trigger. I reveal a mountain and I draw an additional card for the turn. Karanos additional draw. Dictate additional draw. Who wants
all
a new hand?
You really don't.
You really don't, Eric?
It's full only grip. One real card in it, so.
It's a full grip. Do you want 7 new cards?
I would love 7 new cards.
If this shuffles back into my library,
It just gets discarded.
No.
You really want that one card?
I mean, it gets rid of threats at instant speed, so yes.
Okay.
But
I mean, my targets are optional, so if you don't want to discard it, I won't make you discard. Mountain as my land for the turn. I have been really mean to Emily, so I'll go ahead and blue. 2. I have been really mean to Emily.
I just really wish people would stop pointing at life counter.
Wheel and deal. Any number of target opponents each discards his or her hand and draws 7. I'm only going to choose Emily.
I can't do it.
I'm not choosing you. But I am choosing you for this 10 damage to your face.
Well, fine then.
I get to draw a card off of Wheel and Deal. I investigate off of Trail of Evidence.
Yeah, something else, I'm dead.
I can have a few something else's. So, blue, red, 1, 2, 3, 4 is not worth it. Tell you what is worth it, though, is blue, 1, 2, 3 for Jachi the Memory Adept.
Not the super broken.
I'm gonna be pseudo political here.
While you're being pseudo political.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Babe, mill 10.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30. 10.
Okay, there was an Eldritch the Binding Blade in there that might be troublesome.
I'm gonna go ahead and draw a card and exile a card from the SOS Gateway.
Sure.
I'm gonna exile the Swamp.
I don't know that one.
Combat. One, three, a 0/1, and a 0/3.
I have jump blockers. And she's useless from now on.
I'm just gonna pass turn, Ludovic trigger, I get to draw a card.
Thrasios.
May I have a dice bag?
Thrasios. Thrasios.
You know these Thrasios reveals are draw, not milled.
Hmm.
Okay, you were just setting them down.
Yeah.
It looked like you were putting them in your grave.
I know. My God.
What made you what?
Milton.
Jace. His zero ability in the middle is target player mills 10.
This still seems kind of broken.
That's fine.
It's zero. It's no up, no down.
Yeah.
Folks from the Blind Eternities.
This can be really bad.
Destroy everything. Unless he gets Ulamog, he might get Ulamog.
Well, the one thing I really want gone, Ulamog, is about the only thing we can get it.
The Sphinx Bone Bomb?
This is the
3, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Ulamog. Let's go here. Planeswalker.
Not that one?
Nah.
That one didn't hurt him. They are exiled.
I will then suspend Search for Tomorrow. Two home counters on it.
I really want to clear the board.
A what?
I said I really want to clear the board.
I mean, you're not the only one.
Look at the bright side. All he has to do is a lot of his 9 damage to his face. He's a red deck. He's got this.
That's true. And he already has 3.
I don't have.
You have 3. You have 3.
That's true.
You just need to get 6.
Mind Unbound. At the beginning of upkeep, pull a counter on it and drop 5 zip counters.
Okay.
Pass turn.
Upkeep. Land tax trigger.
If anything, it pulls the land out of your deck.
Do you what?
I said if anything, it pulls the land out of your deck.
It's the one of the best things about land taxes.
Get a stuffy doll.
I have a stuffy doll.
No, I'm saying like get a stuffy doll.
I because can't.
Draw a stuffy doll.
Let me just do that for you.
Yes.
Why a stuffy doll?
Because I can target stuffy doll with damage a lot easier than I can target your face.
Okay, then.
If he pulls a stuffy doll,
what I really need is Pariah. So the damage is done to the stuffy doll. Cuts. My hands.
So stealing your upkeep. You want to exile anything.
Yeah, I'm good. He hasn't messed with me.
Exactly.
That Ulamog isn't messing with anybody.
No, it's probably going
that.
To you.
Mm-hmm.
We can't exile that. Artifact or enchantment.
I know.
Okay.
I'm saying he has the biggest threat on the board.
True.
I also have
a lot of rocks.
Discard and pass the turn. It's nice having land. Just wish I could play more than one turn.
Right?
Still drawing two, right?
Yes.
Imagine if Howling Mine had been out.
Temple the False God.
I don't think I drew my second. Yeah.
Getting a land?
No, the first one I drew was land.
I'm gonna play Sphinx's Tutelage.
Move.
We're gonna have a mill battle here.
I mean, your deck is the worst target with Sphinx's Tutelage because of how many colorless cards you have.
Yeah. But you two are mill battle.
I'm gonna draw a card and exile a card targeting Austin with Sphinx's Tutelage.
I know, I've seen it. It's awful. It's
peer through that.
Exiling Baleful Strix.
Can anybody make that Ulamog not indestructible?
Actually, I can.
Oh, sweet. On my turn, we can kill it.
Okay. Oh, wait. I need one more blue mana to do that. Sorry.
Did you use your blue mana?
Yeah.
On...
Well, I had to.
Oh, on Sphinx's Tutelage. Grr.
Well, I guess I would if I had to discard an extra card for that second draw.
Gonna play Worn Power Stone.
That's a lot of money.
There is not a single card in the
I might be able to if Eric lets me hit him.
Do what?
I'll try it. Forward, Eric.
It's $5. That's gotta be more than any other
card. Oblation, shuffle into your library, draw two cards.
Draw how many cards?
Two.
Two.
So you shuffle Madomai in. After you're done shuffling and we cut, you draw two cards.
I wanted to see where
approach was.
Yeah.
Well, we know it wasn't in her hand. If she's looking for it.
It's at the bottom, honest.
In the middle.
Middle-ish.
The bottom third.
Oh, it doesn't matter. Come on.
It wasn't the next card.
I would have been mad.
I would have been so happy and then sad when you drew it off the
ablation. I'm
going to
be sad if she does.
I draw three, right?
Two. Stop trying to cheat.
I'm not trying to cheat. Okay. Oh, I draw two cards.
Yeah, she draws two cards.
It's
Eric
fine.
For one trigger, and you for the second trigger.
So it's two, and if they match...
If they match, do it again. So you're
well,
good.
That was a red sun that we wanted.
I'm sad. I'm sorry.
I'm sad, too.
All done.
The Sunforger would have been sweet, too, except I don't have a creature to play.
Untap, upkeep, draw trigger.
Oh, wait, am I just playing?
Draw trigger reveals counterspell. Caleb, take three.
5, 6, 7. No, I'll discard something highly.
Second draw from Dictator Krufix.
So that's so I'm aware that there are still cards I need to make a cube bed.
Play my land for the turn. I'm gonna go ahead and plus one Jace to draw a card. Emily mill one.
Scepter has been here the whole game.
Oh yeah, I'm amazed that Isochron Scepter's still here.
It hasn't ever been the biggest threat.
Somehow.
It's still been doing work, though.
Alright, we're going all in, folks. I am casting Epic Experiment for 8. First cast trigger. Let's reveal. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8.
Not that many.
Nope, but it is hilarious.
No, let's look at the small ones.
So these all immediately go to grave because I can't cast them. They'll end up there when it resolves. We're going in the casting order. Tutor, Mortars, and Fate so that they resolve in the opposite order. Okay. Wheel of Fate resolves. Everybody discard your hand and draw 7 cards.
Only real card I had was a Scour from Existence.
Yeah. Still no Birch.
Mizzium Mortars is going to resolve. And I'll hit Thrasios. And then Mystical Tutor will resolve. And I search my library for an instant or sorcery. Reveal it and put it on top.
I drew 7 cards.
Do what?
I drew 7 cards.
Yes.
Who are the triggers going at? All 7 of him?
So two at each of you and 1 extra at Austin.
So first trigger.
Are you
don't
sure you
color.
Don't want me to have a guaranteed 3 damage to Caleb?
Yes.
Second trigger, don't share a color.
None of mine shared.
None of your shared.
So I'm getting 3 triggers?
Yes.
Where is it? There it is. I'm going to reveal Past in Flames.
What do?
Instance and sorceries in my graveyard gain flashback. And since it's going to the top of my library, it's getting milled. And it has flashback.
Sorry.
No, it has flashback. I can cast it out of my grave.
Okay.
Short one more.
1, 2, 1, 2, 1, 2.
Okay.
None of those shared a color?
Nope.
Wow.
There was a land in each 2.
Seems fine.
Mine was all colored, but everything was lots of colors.
Blue green.
Yeah.
You want to put your instructable against my instructable?
Combat. Pass combat. I will end of the turn. Caleb lost life. I draw a card off of
the deck. Did you use Jace that turn?
Yeah, I drew a card with
him. Okay.
Yes.
One tap. Upkeep. I'm not supposed to make two. Draw a card off that one. Draw step, 2.
Can I see your graveyard?
Suspend trigger.
Yes, you may see all the land in my graveyard.
It's mostly land.
There's some stuff in there.
That's a Gisela.
Gisela
trigger. Yeah. The 4 red
cell. Well, I might be able to use its land.
If you're casting it from grave without paying its mana cost, X always
zero.
Equals 0.
Thing with yours. I want to see yours, please.
I'm the one. So even with Past in Flames?
No, with Past in Flames, you're actually paying a cost.
Okay.
She would be casting it without
sure.
paying its mana cost,
sure,
in
sure.
which case X equals 0.
That's it.
How many bases?
She's going to gamble for approach, in which case we really hope she discards it.
How much... How many basic lands do you run in this?
Way too many.
If you've got Boundless Realms, you'll find most of them.
Okay.
You gotta remember, we shuffled all of them back in that were destroyed by Armageddon.
I was just making sure.
There's a pretty good amount. Like, normally when I Boundless Realms, it's usually for like 15 or 16, and I'm still only like 3 or 4 off.
I'm excited.
If I wasn't tapped out, I could kill them.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 basics. 1, 2. Waste, yeah.
Oh, it's each opponent.
Yeah, you get 1 out of everybody's group.
8. 9.
That would be nice.
Double your land count.
Is that what like how the card reads?
Boundless made that Armageddon off the top.
Destroy all lands.
Boundless Realms assert your library.
I already did it once.
A
scan.
Number of basic lands equal to the number of lands you control.
Number of lands.
Yeah, so it's double your land
what?
Count.
2, 3, 4.
Yeah.
I don't like
there's
it.
There's destroy all.
Doing
any players.
Combat.
Decree of annihilation.
Yeah,
do you
like
just
wipe
shirt? Does anybody have a response to him moving into combat?
Everything, including their hands.
Eric. any what? Response to him moving into combat.
I really wish I did, but no.
It's okay. Not coming at you.
And I appreciate
attack
that.
Attack trigger. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20. Attack trigger is resolved. All of these go to exile, block with Karakos.
Okay. This is the longest I've played without actually casting my commander.
Ulamog, the Ceaseless Hunger's attack trigger is defending player exiles the top 20 cards of their library.
That sounds fun.
It's awful.
Four attacks and
yeah.
half a combat.
It's a, yeah.
Life's Legacy, sack me here, drawing a ton.
Sure.
So it does that to you two more times and you have no library and you lose?
Except
for
you
ten.
Just sacked it, man. It's just weird.
It's the biggest thing I had, and that's about all I could do.
I mean, now he, now Kaidel taps for 10, 11, 12, 13 mana.
Forgot about that. Thank you.
Why are you telling him?
He just got 11 mana out of his library, so. Man.
I mean, he's basically drawing gas.
If he ever gets 30 mana, though, he wins.
That's an Ugin.
You should do it.
Did you pay the tax on that?
Yes, I will.
Sure. So, 9 out of 13, you have 4 colorless mana left.
That's
4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17. 17 mana. That's 14. Using 3 of it, 1 green. One colorless.
Sure, you did not pay the tax.
So I have.
Or did you?
I will. Actually, I'll use the one flood.
Sure.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Paying the tax. Flood one more.
So there is a. Because that's going to shut down Isochron Scepter. There's actually a rare opportunity here. Normally when you play a Planeswalker, you retain priority to activate the ability, but the abilities can only be activated at sorcery speed, so since he has proceeded past activating the ability and doing other things, you can deal damage to the Planeswalker before he can activate the ability. Also, once Void Winnower resolves, you can't use Isochron Scepter to cast Lightning Helix.
I'm going to go ahead and activate it.
Gonna do it.
I feel like his face
no,
is a better target.
You, because okay. I actually want you to exile all colored permanents.
Okay.
His face?
Through to you.
Not his face?
Not his face. He's at 6 life, and I'm playing a burn deck, essentially.
I don't have to ever tap out.
Oh.
No tax.
Correct.
So are we going three now, or is it still two?
It takes...
The biggest thing that I don't have.
It takes 5 to clear everything.
Alright, 5.
So it's just color permanents, right?
Yes.
Exiled?
Yes. Karanos is finally exiled.
I was fine with it because it didn't affect my board that much.
Wait, colored permanents, not lands?
Yes.
You're right.
Yes, lands too?
No,
no,
lands are okay. Colorless. Anyways.
Oh, that's right.
Away
but yes, it is non-land permanents.
Two.
Mind unbound ground two?
Do what?
Is mind unbound ground?
No,
five
he did it for 5.
Oh.
And mind unbound is 6.
Pass turn.
You're
oh,
on
that's right.
Thread.
Jace is exiled. I forgot
yep.
Jace was hanging
you're
out.
You're hanging
over there.
On by a thread, kid.
Yes,
I am. I also have no idea what I'm doing with this deck. So,
well, you're in a pretty good position with a Void Winnower and a new game.
We still have the
why
double draw.
No.
Yes.
No.
No, 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 that's
gone
now.
It's gone.
Okay. And remember, you can't do anything even.
Why do you still have the mind on?
He did it for five.
Oh, okay. Wait, it's a six.
That is the third time I've answered that question.
That was actually the only thing I really wanted to keep.
Okay, I was going to ask if you got rid of From Beyond, because that is technically powerless.
Yep.
Yeah.
Playing Jay Ballard.
Yeah. You going to discard some of those land cards you're taxing up? Or were taxing up?
Probably.
Dag. Dag.
He might need one bigger than that.
Yeah. We'll go and plus her up, get a six. I'm going to discard three lands and draw three cards.
I actually can't cast Past in Flames now. Because even though the flashback cost is five, the CMC is four.
Yay! I'm going to die mercilessly next turn, hopefully.
Hopefully, he says.
Well, I do have an awesome hand. I'm not gonna lie, this is pretty. I have no idea what I'm doing.
I will pass turn.
I'm gonna play this prairie stream. I'm gonna do weird things this turn.
New goal. Deck this out.
5, 6, 7. Diluvian Primordial. I want Gamble from you. I need to see your paper.
Sure.
Cast instants and sorceries.
Yes. And she can't grab an even mana cost card. Oh, actually, that's a good point. He has Scour from Existence, which is both odd and removal for the Oblivion Sire.
Boundless Realms from him.
Or the Void
Realm. Where's your Gamble?
I exiled it, because that's what happens after Diluvian casts it.
Oh, well, I was going to have them in order over here so I could see what I'm doing. Can I just have it for a little bit?
Sequencing matters here, because there's a Void Realm.
I'll take that.
I mean, sequencing doesn't matter, because
she
has
Octron's Customs.
I just want to see what I'm doing.
I'm not saying anything against you. I was referring to Josh being incorrect.
Hey, if this doesn't bother your deck, it shuts him out, so why kill
it? It doesn't shut me out at all.
Wow.
I can almost kill you next turn.
Hey.
With that card on the field.
You still have to try.
Okay, first I'm going to Boundless Realms, so it's double my land count.
They're coming into play tap.
Yeah, I know. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So I get 6 lands?
6 basics into play tap.
One, two, three, four, five.
Get one more. Someone
six.
Finally recovered from an Armageddon.
And while I'm doing that, I'll go ahead and do gamble.
You don't count.
You're not a person.
Well then.
Do I have to reveal when I grab?
No.
I mean, you can't scatter, no. I mean,
we know what you're grabbing.
Okay.
We hope you discard it.
And then...
You have to finish resolving the gamble.
Yeah, that's what I would rather do
approach
anyway, so I know where to turn.
Five, right?
Seven.
Seven?
Approach
seven.
Is seven. It's seven mana, seven life, seventh card from the top.
Okay.
That's a lot of sevens.
It's coming down
two,
next.
3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Roll the d8.
You're rolling an 8.
With the 6th card.
2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Not approach.
Not approach.
Okay, not approach at the 2nd side. We're in trouble, folks.
Hey, I can probably find an answer.
I've got an answer in my hand.
Okay. But can you play the answer and kill me?
The answer might help me kill you.
I should probably get rid of Void Winnower.
Probably.
Yeah, Void Winnower. Exile.
But why?
Because reasons.
Reasons that we love to hate.
Hey, you can start bolting people again.
Yes, you can.
Best day ever.
I'll pay 3 for an obelisk. And then I'll play 3 for Pilgrim's Eye.
My kingdom for an next spell.
Basic. Put it in my hand. Okay, revealing an island. And then I will pass turn.
Untap. Upkeep. And draw.
Pets.
So, mountain. So I need red, 1, and then I need to pay 1, so I will leave one colorless mana floating. Collective Defiance. Modes are 3 damage to your face, you discard your hand and draw that many cards. And red with the one colorless floating. Price of Progress deals 2 damage to each player for each non-basic they control.
Shoot.
You're dead.
You have 2.
I take 4.
1, 2, 3, 4.
You
take
8.
Let's see what I get done next.
So I should have actually pressed this bounty first, but it didn't matter too much. Crack a clue and draw a card, because clues are colorless. I'm going to crack another clue and draw a card. Pass turn.
End of your turn.
Now we have to work really, really hard to kill Eric.
Ice Crown set for you.
Yep.
Trigger flips. Untap. Draw. Play land for turn.
Ugh, I need my Eye of the Storm.
Nobody needs that.
Eye of the Storm is my best hope of beating you. Because with Eye of the Storm, I can mill you out. And milling you at this point is a lot easier than dealing 64 damage.
I'm going to plus to add 3 red mana. You can use it for
next turn.
It's in their sorceries. I'm going to tap this for red.
Uh-oh.
I'm going to use 2 of the floating for insult. It copies.
Yep, so damage can't be prevented and is quadrupled.
Yep.
Pretty sure we die.
You do. Do as I concept.
So let's count this out.
Do you have your Comet Storm?
No.
Do you have another X spell that targets?
I don't have an X spell that targets now.
Stupid Isochron Scepter.
I'll tap for a red and a white. Add 2 more red. I still have the red floating, but it's not going to really matter. Play Furnace of Wrath.
Okay.
Yep.
Damage is doubled on top of being quadrupled.
So it's hextupled?
No, it's octupled. 2 to 4.
So far you can kill either one of us.
I'm gonna, before I forget, I'm gonna use that
floating mana.
Floating red. Yes. I'm going to where?
Destroy that.
Destroy it. And then I will cast Lightning Helix.
Sure. Who dies? honestly, it's probably easier for him to kill me in the later game.
Yeah. I'm gonna kill you.
Okay.
3, 6, 12, 24. Yep.
And then I gain 3.
10, 20.
The burn spell's winning!
Dude, this deck's so much fun. I will pass turn.
Untap, upkeep, and draw. So, land for the turn. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Leaves me with 4 mana. But then I do 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Then I get 9.
So if you're going to kill her, why bother removing the thing?
Honestly, because I had the mana open and I just decided to do it. Wasn't thinking. And I forgot he had artifacts buried over there, it looks like.
Yeah.
One is a signet.
I mean, still a thing I could have targeted.
Or stay repaired. Because the one mana doesn't actually have that big of an impact on my turn for this game. On my play for this turn. So I have to do this first to do anything, to do more than one thing. So red, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Red, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Red 6, Brass's Bounty, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. I get 9 treasure tokens.
That's good.
I'm going to use 6 of them for Sunbird's Invocation. I have 3 left. To have any hope here, I really just have to spend that 3 and 2 to time reversal. Sunbird trigger. I can cast anything 5 or less. We're going to commit your Isochron Scepter.
Sure. Do a second top.
Time reversal resolves. We shuffle our hand and graveyard into our library and draw 7 cards.
May actually be better for me.
I know. But it was literally like my only hope to do anything.
Yeah.
I was really hoping to hit a turnabout in there, but I think turnabout was in my grave.
I don't think I had a Bane of Fire yet. It's a shame.
Is that the one where if you go 5 or higher it can't be countered?
Can't be countered. Oh. Yeah, it's both of those. Draw 7.
I already played my land for the turn, so I might as well quicken.
How?
Can't cast that. Draw a card, and I'm gonna die. Pass turn to Eric.
Oh, yeah, it's going to be sweet.
Turnabout was exiled, that's what it was.
Aetherflux Reservoir.
You want to just kill me off of that?
I will pay 50 life to deal 50 damage to you.
That was a good game.
Good
game.
Hold on, show them what's in your hand.
So what I drew was...
Oh, that's amazing.
Love this deck.
You just weren't a threat until it was too late.
Did you
and it wasn't even that it was you were a threat, it was your life total.
Yeah.
It
wasn't even that you were a threat, it was your life total compared to everyone else's.
Off of the new...
Sunburn, because Fire Song just
we're done.
Game.
Yeah, I threw in the new Wincon of Aetherflux Reservoir.
That's a
fun
card.
I did. Because nobody was targeting me, even though it's at like 50 plus life for most of that game.
It's the misconception that people think. Oh.